Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm back here at the deck redo site, and I'm gonna make some bar stools. Let me flip you around and show you. So here's the bar that we built, and you walk up to it, it's 42 inches high for bar height, but there's nowhere to sit. So yesterday I was at Menards and I got the missing banister rail there that I had to pick up. I went ahead and I picked up 10 more of those, and we're gonna make bar stools out of them. Again, it's treated lumber, and let's get started. So here's my 10 2x2s, and then I picked up one deck board for the seat, so it'll be like the frame and legs and then the seat. And I Googled, just asked Siri how tall are bar stools, and she says they're 30 inches, so these are 42s. We're gonna cut the beveled end off and get them down to 30 inches. All right, so I went ahead and changed the bevel from 45 to 10, and then I did it same on both ends, so it'll have a little slant to it, should make it a little more sturdy. And 30 inches just didn't seem quite long enough, so I went with 34, and if that's too tall, we can cut them down. So it's 34 inches with 10 degree bevel on both ends right now. Okay, now what I've done is I've cut two by twos at 15 inches with a 45 on each end, and then two at 10 inches with a 45 on each end, so they'll go together in a square. It'll be 10 by 15, okay, like that. And then our deck board, it's a 5.5 wide, so we'll center it at 5 inches, and then that'll give us a half inch off each end, and then we'll cut it 16 inches to give us a half inch off both sides. Okay, so we got our two deck boards, and they're going to sit on about like that. That'll be our seat, so now we'll screw it together. So here's our seat, looking pretty good. We used 3-inch screws like this, the Torx heads. Okay, it goes in like this on both sides, and then I like these deck screws to hold this down like this. Something to point out. See how this grain is running? We got both those turned down because as this is really wet right now. As it dries, it's going to try to curve like this, and we'd rather it curve like that than like this. So we turned those. That's called the crowning. We turned that crowning down. Now we'll screw our legs on. So there's my legs screwed on. Again, I got 10 degrees right on the legs on both ends. We just got one 2.5-inch screw from the back side holding it to here, and then I've cut my supports, did these at 10 degrees also, and I think my length is roughly 15 inches, but we'll set them up here on the leg, and then we'll just move it up until the both sides match up. It's going to be about right there, and then we'll screw those on. All right, so we got the framework screwed in all the way around, and I got one going into the legs and then one going into the next frame, and it's trying to crack. And so I had these 3-inchers. I'm gonna have to go get some 2.5 that are like these Torx to replace them with. But that turned out okay. So it's 15 here, or no, 14 here, and then 17 on the long side. Then I had to double up down here because it was really wobbly. So I'll only get one done today, but where I just had one earlier, I went ahead and doubled around, and that really stiffened it up. All right, I just got it finished up. I'm excited to show it to you, so let me flip you around and you'll see what we did. And here it is. I've sat on it. It sits good. It's 30 inches tall. Fits our bar just right. I don't think it looks too bad. One thing I did do is I added a step right there, so when you sit down, you can put your feet on it. When I sat down, it just felt like my legs were hanging. It really wasn't great. I might even add one to the bar also, a 2x4 or something across there to put your feet on. But when you sit there, it's pretty comfortable. No back on it. I don't think back's necessary. But that's it. So that's just a real quick morning project for under 10 bucks. I'll get some more 2x2s and I'm going to do another one. That one turned out pretty good. So thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.